The thing about EDC videos is that until they become a permanent feature of the channel, I feel like I have to explain what EDC is every time. This might be the last one. EDC stands for Everyday Carry. It's basically a community, a tradition, if you will, of showing people the things that you carry with you every day, hence Everyday Carry, because it gives people an insight on certain solutions that they could adopt to their own lifestyle. The thing about EDC videos is that they're kind of like unboxing videos in a way. Like, I shouldn't enjoy that. It doesn't make sense that I like it, but I like both watching it and creating that kind of content. Go figure. Anyway, this is my everyday carry for this week, and I'm gonna go over some of the items here. Of course, I framed this wrong, so I forgot to include my phone. I guess I should. This is an ROG Phone 2. I got this from Asus at their launch event in Taiwan. It was my first time visiting Asia. It was amazing, and I got a new phone out of it, which is even better. This is what they call a gaming phone. It has outrageous specs. Like, depending on where you are in the world, this might actually be better than the computer you're watching this video on right now. It's pretty wild. The best feature of this phone is not even the specs, which are ridiculous for a cell phone, but it's the fact that it has shoulder triggers. Not sure if I'm gonna get my camera to focus here. There we go. These right here are touch sensitive, and you can map these in games. So for instance, when I'm playing COD Mobile, this aims, this fires. That improves the gameplay experience like you wouldn't believe. Because of my work covering technology on YouTube, I have a lot of stuff. These are just the ones that I could reach because I didn't want to get up. These are some of the ones that I have here on my table. I have a lot of phones. I've used every kind of phone you can think of. And this is the one that finally won me over because of the triggers. I'm huge into portable gaming, so as you can imagine, a crazy fast phone that I can play online first-person shooters on and has triggers? It's a no-brainer. Then you have perhaps the quaintest item in my EDC. This is a little notepad, an ordinary notepad. It was given to me by the people over at the Brazil conference that happened in Harvard and MIT back in 2019. I was a featured speaker at the event. I was talking about content creation and such, and they gave us a little bag with a bunch of, you know, little gifts, and this is one of them. And I use these to write down video ideas. My handwriting, as you can see, is miserable. I fluctuate between writing in Portuguese and writing in English. For this one, though, it's all Portuguese. Then we have these, my aviators. These are prescription, as you can imagine. Eyewear technology has gotten to the point where you can have a frame like this and not look like you stuck two Coke bottle bottoms to your face. You try saying that three times fast. Coke bottle bottoms. Anyway, as I was saying, it's funny because when I bought these, I didn't actually think these would suit my face and the style of clothing that I usually wear. I didn't like it that much, but I asked on Twitter, people said, yeah, go for it. I have I have these Wayfarers, so even if I hated these, it's like, okay, it's spare pair of sunglasses if you end up losing yours, because I lose sunglasses all the freaking time. But in the end, I actually like this quite a bit. Next up, you have this, the 8-bit dough do. Have we decided how you actually pronounce these guys' company? Anyway, because every video I've ever watched, it's like a different way to say it. 8-bit dough. Let's go with 8-bit dough. Anyway, this one right here is the SN30 Pro. It's, as you can see, basically a Super Famicom controller, the color buttons give it away, with analogs and four shoulder triggers. Now, I've had pretty much every single one of the controllers that this company makes. I've had a bunch of them, but I never use them that much. They're great to pair with your Switch, but I only ever pair it to my Switch when I go to my dad's house to play with my younger siblings. However, this now never leaves my bag. And you know why? Game Pass Ultimate. As I mentioned in a previous video, I have fallen in love with the idea of playing Xbox games on my phone, wherever I am, with a Bluetooth controller. I have this little stand here on my phone, so I just prop it like this, and I pair the controller, which I just have to press start and hold, and there you go. I'm playing Gears of War 2 on my phone with a controller, no matter where I am. Amazing. Then, my vape pen. This is a cheap kind. I don't know what these are actually called. A bunch of different brands make them. This is basically the battery right here, and this is the cartridge with the THC oil. As you know, I live in Canada where weed and weed products are legal. I've been recommended this by my doctor to help with insomnia and anxiety, and it helped tremendously. All the meds I was taking, they were not working anymore, and I hated the side effects. Plus, it makes movies funnier, so it's a win-win. Right here, as you could have guessed, inside this cool little Game Boy metal case, I have more weed. I have the capsules, I have the vape pen cartridges. I have far more than I need. This will usually last me a lot because I don't use it that much. But I like having options, so I have a bunch. Right here, we have my Bluetooth earbuds. They're by a brand called Urban Ears. I had never heard of them before buying these. I found these at Best Buy. The price was okay and the reviews were pretty positive, so I decided to pull the trigger on them. The bass, as can be expected with small, cheap earbuds, isn't, you know, amazing, but it's good enough. And I very much like the fact that it charges over USB-C, which is also the case with my controller, and is also the case with my phone. Since leaving Apple's walled garden, this has been one of the best things ever. Being able to charge all the things I own, aside from the vape pen, which requires its own little dongle, like this. You screw this on here, and then you connect this to any old USB port, and there you go, it charges your vape battery. Everything else, USB Type-C. And finally, this, a Fruit to Go by Sunripe, not sponsored by the way, though I wish I buy a lot of these things. This is basically a healthier snack alternative than pulling into the drive-thru. It's gluten-free for those who care. I don't have any allergies or anything like that, so it doesn't matter to me. But it is vegan, it's gluten-free, it's nut-free. It's only 45 calories, and I'm no nutritionist, but looking at the back here, it's not the worst thing you could be putting into your body. It's pretty decent. This, sometimes having this in my bag or in my car, is the difference between munching on something that's a little healthier for you and spending money on a Big Mac. And let's be honest, when you pull into that drive-thru, you're not just buying a Big Mac. So this is my EDC for this week. What do you usually carry with you? Let me know in the comments down below. Follow me on social media. I'm very active over there, both Twitter and Instagram. I usually share behind-the-scenes stuff. Actually, I'll do it right now. Check it out. All right, just wrapping up a new EDC video. This is going to be on YouTube in... I'm going to be optimistic and say 2 hours. You want to see what that looked like from the other end? Go check my Instagram. And that's all the time I have for today. I'm Izzy, and I'm done. And not look like you stuck to Coke bottle. And not look like you stuck to Coke bottom. And not look like you stuck two Coke bottle bottoms.